Bihar Assembly polls. Can Nitish make a comeback? Nitish Kumar continues to be the central figure in Bihar politics. Notwithstanding the fact that he does not have the political muscle or organizational wherewithal to win an assembly election on his own. His Janata Dal United, JDU, has in fact just once emerged as single largest vote aggregator in an assembly election. That's in 2010, following a well-appreciated first term. JDU polled 22.5% votes in the 2019 Bihar Assembly election. In October 2005 polls, the JDU got nearly 20.5% votes. Moreover, his first term in 2000 had lasted just for 8 days. However, except for 9 months rule of Jitin Manjhi, Nitish Kumar has indeed ruled Bihar for over almost 15 years without any interruption. Interestingly, despite this long run at the helm of affairs in Bihar, many are convinced of Nitish Kumar's JDU getting an extra 3-4% vote due to its alliance with the BJP, which has a committed vote bank. The BJP RSS cadres help the JDU get extra votes on certain seats. This relation does not work the other way round in the same measure, they say. Yet, the Bihar Assembly election of 2015 gave a peek into this electoral arrangement. In 2015, Nitish Kumar contested the Bihar Assembly election with the RJD and the Congress, having broken away from the BJP-led NDA. Nitish Kumar parted ways ahead of the 2014 Lok Sabha polls as he did not want to accept BJP's decision to project Narendra Modi as their prime ministerial candidate. But better wisdom prevailed as he realized that he cannot get along with corrupt RJD headed by a scam convict Lalu Prasad Yadav and Sonia Gandhi's Congress. Hence, he returned back to the NDA fold within a year. This is what Nitish Kumar told media when he decided to sever his party alliance with RJD and Congress. Listen to him.
ये दो पॉलिटिकल लोगों के बीच की बात है, हम आपको कैसे शेयर करेंगे? कभी शेयर नहीं करेंगे. क्या बात होती है? प्रेम से बात होती है, चाहे अमित शाह जी से हो या माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी नरेंद्र मोदी जी से हो, प्रेम से बात होती है. अब उसमें हम क्या शेयर करें? कोई शेयर करने की चीज़ है? लेकिन इतना तय बात है कि बीजेपी और जेडीयू के बीच में बिहार के संदर्भ में किसी तरह का कोई मतभेद नहीं, और न राजनीतिक मतभेद है, न प्रशासनिक कार्यों के संचालन में किसी तरह का कोई मतभेद है. हम लोग बहुत अच्छे ढंग से काम करते रहते हैं, लेकिन सुनते रहते हैं इधर उधर से क्या करेंगे.
Though there were efforts from his newfound friends and party colleagues like Prashant Kishore, a self-acclaimed sophologist, and former bureaucrat Pawan Kumar Verma to wean Nitish away from NDA fold, however, did not succeed. Their efforts to create rift between their leader Nitish and PM Modi failed to succeed. They were in turn expelled from the party. What does it convey? 69-year-old Nitish, in fact, may be fighting his last polls to reoccupy the Chief Minister's gaddi. Nitish Kumar's ability to seek the Bharatiya Janata Party's support and yet maintain an arm's length from its ally has been the hallmark of his politics. One may even call it a mantra to survive in a polity which had all the ingredients to go bipolar between Saffron Brotherhood on one side and Lalu Prasad Yadav's Rashtriya Janata Dal, that is RJD, on the other. Bihar was the first state to pass a resolution against the proposed National Register of Citizens, NRC, last year, opening the floodgates for other states to follow suit. He supported demonetization, yet did not join in the Union Council of Ministers after being offered fewer than expected berths. Interestingly, the BJP too seems not in a great hurry to conquer Bihar on its own. The misadventure in the last assembly polls might have taught a lesson or two, though it managed to retain its numbers. In that context, the BJP's new chief, JP Nadda, made his party's intentions clear, stating that his party has no longer plans to do it alone. Instead, he reiterated that his party is committed to fight the upcoming polls in November along with JDU and also under the leadership of Nitish Kumar.
मेरे लिए ये सौभाग्य की बात है कि मुझे कार्य समिति की इस बैठक में आने का सौभाग्य मिला और बिहार के वरिष्ठतम कार्यकर्ताओं के साथ मुलाकात करने का मौका मिला है। बिहार और पटना जो मेरी जन्मभूमि रही है, उनके साथ और उसके साथ मेरा भावनात्मक लगाव है और ऐसी महावीर की भूमि, ऐसी हमारी भगवान बुद्ध की भूमि, गुरु गोविंद सिंह की भूमि को मैं नमन करता हूँ। बिहार के बारे में हम सब लोग जानते हैं कि एक विशेष स्थान राष्ट्र की राजनीति में बिहार ने रखा है, फिर चाहे वो राजनीतिक विषय हो, फिर चाहे वो सामाजिक पक्ष हो, फिर चाहे वो सांस्कृतिक पक्ष हो, हर एक पक्षों में बिहार ने हम सबको नेतृत्व किया है। फणेश्वरनाथ रेणु, रामधारी सिंह दिनकर से लेकर के अगर हम राष्ट्र के दृष्टि से उत्थान की बात करें और विकास की बात करें तो उसमें भी जो बिहार का योगदान रहा है वो अविस्मरणीय है। हम सब लोग उस बात को जानते हैं अच्छी तरीके से। ऐसी धरती को मैं नमन करता हूँ और नमन करने के साथ साथ ऐसी धरती से मैं प्रेरणा लेता हूँ जिनके जिस धरती से राजनीतिक, सामाजिक, सांस्कृतिक उत्थान का विकास उत्थान हुआ है, ऐसी धरती को मैं नमन करता हूँ।
Contrary to this, the opposition, spearheaded by JL Lalu Prasad Yadav's Rashtriya Janata Dal and Congress, remains a divided house. In fighting with the RJD between Lalu Prasad's sons, added to the leadership crisis within their ally Congress, and return of JDU-BJP under the NDA banner looks more than certain. This in spite of RJD and Congress reaching seat-sharing formula to take on mighty NDA alliance in the assembly polls. While the RJP is set to contest 160 seats, then the Congress rests 60 in the 243-strong assembly. The two parties also apparently agreed that the RJD will try and accommodate VIP and potential allies CPIML and BSP from its quota of 163 seats. Then the Congress, on the other hand, will adjust the RLSP and HAM and potential ally CPI within share of seats. But the JAM, headed by former Chief Minister Jitin Manjhi, whose decision to walk out of the Grand Alliance to join the NDA has come as a shocker to the RJD as well as Congress. However, political analysts feel Nitish Kumar knew how to change sides to tilt the balance of power and also votes from one end of spectrum to the other. He displayed it successfully in the previous assembly polls. The upcoming elections this year pose a stiffer challenge and the JDU leaders seem to be preparing for the denouement well in advance. Nitish Kumar's endeavors in Bihar for long have been helped by the BJP's inability to develop strong local leadership. The current party dispensation in Delhi wants to change all this. The promotion of Sanjay Jaiswal, who comes from the same caste group as Sushil Modi, is a testimony to that. Nityanand Raj and Giriraj Singh, also seen as strong proponents, bringing the BJP out of shadows of the JDU. In sharp contrast, the BJP, realizing its strengths and weaknesses, chooses to sail with RJD, at least for another term, before it could develop a strong leader who will enjoy wider acceptance across Bihar. Yes, what the party did exactly in Maharashtra, where it waited quite long to emerge as the single largest party to stake claim. But the greedy Shiv Sena's decision to walk out and join hands with Sharad Pawar's NCP and Sonia-headed Congress to form the Agadi government, denying BJP after the last polls, is a different story. And the Shiv Sena's decision to join hands with rejected parties is now proving quite disastrous with the actor Sushant Singh Rajput's suspicious death in Mumbai. As a result, the actor's mysterious death probe, which has become international news to defend the Agadi government in Maharashtra, is also bound to have its impact on the poll prospects of RJD Congress in most politically volatile Bihar. That looks certain as it works out a double whammy to NDA to retain power. This is MS Purthi for Orange News 9 TV.
For unbiased, accurate and in-depth news analysis, watch Orange News 9 TV on YouTube. Subscribe. Press bell icon, like, comment and share. Edited and promoted by seasoned journalist Emma Shankar.